In the day's other news, the CDC issued a stronger recommendation for both passengers and employees to wear face masks on planes, trains, and buses. The guidance is more specific than previous statements, and it comes to infections are surging again. All told, the U.S. has recorded 8.2 million confirmed infections and 220,000 deaths. The U.S. Justice Department today formally sued Google for allegedly abusing its power in online search and advertisements. The lawsuit claimed that the search giant has effectively created a monopoly that harms competition and consumers. Google called the suit, quote, deeply flawed. We'll have a full report after the news summary. Election Day is now exactly 2 weeks away, and President Trump is back on the road tonight, this time in Pennsylvania. Earlier in a TV interview, the president warned again that a win by Democrat Joe Biden would be a victory for the left wing.
The American dream, the great American dream versus being a socialist hellhole. They're going to turn us into a socialist nation. We're going to be no different than Venezuela. And I'll tell you what, it can happen.
On the Democratic side, former Vice President Biden continued his preparation for Thursday's final presidential debate. His running mate, Senator Kamala Harris, addressed a virtual event on early voting in Wisconsin. She rejected the president's warnings and argued that the Democratic agenda is mainstream.
We will invest in people who need help with health care and better schools and child care. We will protect Social Security and Medicare. These are the things that we will do because we understand if we want to build up America's economy, we have to build up working people.
In another development, First Lady Melania Trump canceled plans to travel with the president tonight for her first public appearance, what would have been, since falling ill with COVID-19. Her office said she has a lingering cough. The U.S. and Russia are closer to extending their last major nuclear arms control agreement by 1 year. Moscow said today that it will accept a mutual freeze on the numbers of nuclear warheads that could keep the so-called New START agreement alive, instead of letting it expire in February. The U.S. State Department welcomed the news. We'll look at this later in the program. On Wall Street today, stocks made up a little of Monday's losses. The Dow Jones Industrial Average gained 113 points to close at 28,308. The NASDAQ rose 37 points, and the S&P 500 added 16. And a NASA robotic spacecraft, OSIRIS-REx, swooped down on an asteroid 200 million miles from Earth tonight. As this animation shows, the goal was to grab a sample of rocks from asteroid Bennu and then quickly lift off and return the sample to Earth by 2023. A Japanese spacecraft is already headed back to Earth with samples from another asteroid. Still to come on the NewsHour, going after Google, the Justice Department brings a major antitrust lawsuit against the tech giant. The U.S. and Russia near an agreement to extend a major nuclear arms control agreement. Concerns remain over the security of American votes as Election Day approaches, plus much more.
This is the PBS NewsHour from WETA Studios in Washington and in the West from the Walter Cronkite School of Journalism at Arizona State University.